The time for talking is over, Rishi Sunak believes, and now it's time for a deal on the Northern Ireland Protocol. After months of talks with political leaders in Northern Ireland and in Europe, the Prime Minister appears to be on the brink of landing a historic Brexit deal. But the disclosure by Sky News that King Charles was being lined up to play a key ceremonial role in the final stages of negotiations has hardened the DUP's opposition.
Not only is the Prime Minister naive, if that's what he was planning to do, but this is a cynical use or abuse of the King. He knows that the King's intervention would be seen by many of our supporters as an endorsement of the deal. And he also knows, of course, that in doing so, he was dragging the King into a hugely controversial political issue.
The King was close to being deployed by Number 10 to meet the European Commission President Ursula von der Leyen, with the signing of a new Brexit deal expected imminently. The meeting has now been cancelled. The leading Tory Eurosceptic MP Jacob Rees-Mogg told Sky News bringing in the King would border on constitutional impropriety. Reinforcing the view that a deal may be imminent, Conservative MPs have been put on a three-line whip to be here in the Commons on Monday. But leading Eurosceptic Tory MPs also tell me they fear they're going to be bounced into accepting Mr Sunak's deal with little or no time to study the detail. In a blow to Mr Sunak's hopes of winning over Brexiteers, the former Prime Minister Boris Johnson has signalled he may not back the PM's deal.
I think the best way forward, as I said when I was running the government, is the Northern Ireland Bill.
Urging him instead to pass his own bill, giving ministers powers to defy Brussels. For 2 years, businesses have faced chaos as a result of border checks under the Northern Ireland Protocol. Mr Sunak hopes that's about to change.